I actually have no opening statement for today. I just want to go through with this. I think we've filed the case already. The case has been filed with our prosecutors, and from there we will proceed with the case proper. And hopefully, this issue will be laid to rest the way that it should be when a crime is committed against a citizen of the Republic of the Philippines, and especially this time, we're talking about a member of media who was felled by an assassin's bullets last October 3, or a little more than a month ago. So I'd like to give the floor to Secretary Abalos.
Unang-una, magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat at sa lahat po ng mga nakikinig. Alam niyo, ito'y makasaysayang araw. At gusto kong pasalamatan ng kagawaran na ng opisina ni Secretary Rimulya, ng mga NBI, and of course, ng Philippine National Police. Siguro, iilan lamang ito sa ilang kaso na kung saan talagang nagtulungan ang NBI at ang PNP para talagang resolbahin ang kasong ito. Ito po'y pinag-aralan maigi lahat ng mga testigong dapat kausapin, kinausap. At on the record, I will say that this is one of the fastest nung sumurrender itong gunman. I think it's less than two weeks nung siya'y sumurrender dahil nga siya'y natakot sa buhay niya dahil doon sa cash reward na inoffer natin. From then on, ang daming nangyari. Pero isang pinangako natin ng ating Pangulo na ito'y mareresolba at yung poong gagawin ngayon. So mamaya po, sabihin na lang po sa press conference, inanarate po ito ng ating spokesperson dito. Yun na po ang magiging statement namin. At bilang panghuli, kami po muli ay nakikiramay sa pamilyang Mabasa tungkol dito. At sa ating mga kababayan na nakikinig kayo, umasa kayo. Sa mga susunod pa o may problema kayo, huwag kayo mag-alala. Andito ang Philippine National Police. Andito ang National Bureau of Investigation. Ang DOJ, ang DILG, sama-sama po tayo parati. Magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat.
Thank you for that, Secretary Boying and Secretary Benhar. Now to read the official joint statement, may I call Attorney Eugene Javier of the NBI to read. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Allow me to... Good morning, everyone. Allow me to deliver a brief, not so brief, statement. From the very beginning, the tragic shooting of Percy Lapid indicated that it was part of a larger scheme stemming from a deeper motive. As will be described and detailed in this report, what was discovered from the in-depth investigation of Mr. Lapid's death was the unfortunate transformation of a pillar of justice, the correction pillar, into a deep, large-scale, and systematic criminal organization. Thus, this presentation will show that a criminal organization exists and is embedded within a government office, and that office is none other than the Bureau of Corrections, which controls what the United Nations Office on Crime and Drugs describes as the biggest mega-prison in the world. Percival Carag Mabasa was born on March 14, 1959. He's better known as Percy Lapid. Mr. Lapid was a journalist by profession and known for his hard-hitting and straightforward style. On October 3, 2022, at 8:30 p.m., Mr. Lapid was shot and killed on Aria Street, Santa Cecilia Village in Las Piñas City. He was driving his black Toyota Innova from his house to the studio when two persons riding a motorcycle in tandem situated themselves beside his car and fired three bullets, causing his instantaneous death. The two persons then fled towards Alabang Zapote Road. On October 6, 2022, Secretary Benhur Abalos offered a reward of 500,000 pesos for anyone who would provide crucial information that would lead to the arrest of Mr. Lapid's killers. Alex Lopez then vowed to give another 1 million pesos as reward money. On October 9, 2022, Speaker Martin Romualdez announced that several congressmen jointly contributed 5 million pesos to the reward, which then stood at 6,500,000 pesos. Several pictures of the gunman were published by media and online, and a manhunt began. It was on October 17, 2022, that the gunman, by the name of Joel Escorial, surrendered to the police as he feared for his life, given the reward out and the publicity of the case. He surrendered himself together with a gun that he used to kill Mr. Lapid. After a ballistics analysis was performed, it was determined that indeed, it was the same gun that was used in the killing. After questioning, Joel Escorial revealed that a certain June Villamor had contacted and contracted him to execute the orders to kill Percy Lapid. He revealed that there was one person from the New Bilibid Prison, or NBP, and another from the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology, BJMP, as part of the conspiracy to kill Percy Lapid. In an effort to secure June Villamor within the NBP, the investigators requested NBP, but instead faced resistance, subterfuge, excuses, and all kinds of rebuffs so that NBP officials could avoid the delivery of the inmate to their custody. In fact, on October 17, 2022, the PNP already communicated with certain Bucor officials to secure the co-conspirator to their custody. The Bucor officials denied that there was anyone by that name within their facility. On October 18, 2022, the PNP filed charges against Joel Escorial and other co-conspirators, including June Villamor, making the existence of the co-conspirator a public record. Still, the Bucor remained silent. Later that same day, the chief of the Southern District Police Station of Las Piñas, Police Colonel Jimmy Santos, who heads the Special Investigation Task Group for the Percy Lapid slay, proceeded to NBP to secure the co-conspirator. Again, he was met with much resistance despite the information already having been made public. The receiving Bucor officials hesitated to even touch the request letter indicating that they would be killed if they entertained such a request. They stamped the request letter and handed back the original copy. Police Colonel Santos knew at that moment they would not act at all on that request. On October 19, 2022, another team from the PNP requested for the custody of the co-conspirator within NBP, and the same was again denied. It was only on October 20, 2022, that Bucor officials admitted that the inmate pointed to by Joel Escorial, namely June Villamor, was already dead. Police Colonel Jimmy Santos then proceeded to Eastern Funeral Services to find the body of the co-conspirator. He took a picture of the remains and sent the same to those police in custody of Joel Escorial. Joel then identified and validated that the person was indeed June Villamor, the person who had given him instructions to kill Percy Lapid. The sequence of events implies that the conspirators planned all along to silence June Villamor and cover up the crime, perhaps even before Joel Escorial's surrender. It was after this revelation that the President of the Republic, Ferdinand Romualdez Marcos Jr., gave his order to Secretary Remulla to preventively suspend Director General Gerald Bantag while there was an ongoing investigation. This came after the President was apprised of the situation and made fully aware of the facts revolving around the death of the journalist. He then instructed for General Gregorio Pio Catapang Jr. to be designated as Acting Director General of the Bureau of Corrections. When the order of the President was effected on October 21, 2022, and Director General Bantag was suspended, and General Catapang Jr. stepped in on October 24, 2022, the latter immediately suspended all of Director General Bantag's people. It was found that DG Bantag's people were from BJMP. They were absorbed from BJMP into Bucor and were given very high ranks despite their low ranks in BJMP. This violates item 15 of Civil Service Commission Memorandum Circular No. 3, Series of 2001, which prohibits the promotion of an employee to a position more than 3 salary grades above his or her former position. On the very same day, the sister of the deceased co-conspirator, June Villamor, surfaced and sought help from Senator Rafi Tulfo. Since the senator was in Geneva at this time, it was his brother, Secretary Erwin Tulfo, who took custody of the sister and brought her to the Department of Justice for her to share the information that she had. Upon arrival at the department, she met with Secretary Remulla to share Facebook Messenger messages she exchanged with her deceased brother before he died. She showed messages sent to her at exactly 11:59 a.m. of October 18, 2022. In those messages, it was revealed to her by her deceased brother that if he were to die, the following gangs and persons would be behind it: Commander Alvin Labra of the Batang City Jail Gang, Commander Alfie Peña Redonda of the Happy Go Lucky Gang, and Commander Aldrin Galicia of Sputnik Gang. This declaration may be considered as a dying declaration of the late June Villamor. The most relevant portion of the exchange reads, and I quote, "Te, ingatan mo itong sasabihin ko. Ilabas mo lang ito pag namatay ako dito. Kailangan walang makaalam nito hanggat buhay pa ako. Pag nawala ako, iparating kada Joel na ang sugo tulo na Commander Didi, Sputnik, Happy Go Lucky at BCJ. Tikang sa opisina ang sugo sa era, Commander Aldrin, Commander Labra, Commander Alfie. Basta ingatan mo yan na walang makakaalam hanggat buhay pa ako. Ayaw na damo pangutana." End quote. Translated to Tagalog, it reads, "Te, ingatan mo itong sasabihin ko, ilabas mo lang ito pag namatay ako dito. Kailangan mo lang makakaalam nito hanggat buhay pa ako. Pag nawala ako, iparating mo kila Joel ng utos nang galing sa commander ng Sputnik, Happy Go Lucky at BCJ. Galing ang utos sa opisina at inutos sila Commander Aldrin, Commander Labra at Commander Alfie." End quote. This was a major breakthrough in the case. Secretary Remulla then caused and instructed Acting Director General Katapang Jr. to transfer the custody of those mentioned in the Facebook chat to the custody of the National Bureau of Investigation for further questioning and investigation. So, the 3 commanders mentioned in the dying declaration, plus one more suspect named by a confidential informant, were transferred. There, they revealed all. The relevant information is within the hands of the NBI and the PNP. Thus, through the unique concerted efforts of the National Bureau of Investigation and the Philippine National Police, with guidance from the Department of Justice and Department of Interior and Local Government, a thorough and candid investigation was conducted jointly. As a result, the NBI and PNP have filed 2 murder charges today. The charges are as follows. First, for the murder of Percival Carag Mabasa, better known as Percy Lapid, we have charged Director General Gerald Kitaleg Bantag, DSO Ricardo Soriano Zulueta as principals by inducement. PDLs Denver Batumbacal Mayores, Alvin Cornista Labra, Alvin Micosa Galicia, and Alfie Peña Redonda are likewise charged as principals by indispensable cooperation for the murder of Percy Lapid. Second, for murder of Cristito Villamor Palanya alias June Villamor E. Globa or Crisanto Villamor, nickname Edoy, we have charged Director General Gerald Kitaleg Bantag and DSO Ricardo Soriano Zulueta as principals by inducement. PDLs Alvin Cornista Labra, Alvin Micosa Galicia, Mario Hermones Alvarez, and Joseph Medel Jorfo are charged as principals by indispensable cooperation. I'm sorry. PDLs Christian Dizon Ramak, Ricky Lamigo Salgado, Rodi Pabustan de la Cruz, and Joel Alog Reyes are charged as principals by direct participation. It was found through the investigation that both Director General Gerald Bantag and DSO Ricardo Zulueta were behind the killing of both Percy Lapid and June Villamor. The sworn statements of the PDL show a clear and direct line of communication from Director General and DSO Zulueta to Denver Mayores, who communicate with Alvin Labra, who then coordinated with Aldrin Galicia, who then orchestrated and executed the killing of Percy Lapid through his gang members and his gang members' contacts on the outside, ultimately ending with gunman Joel Escorial and his group. With respect to June Villamor, the same sworn statements of the PDLs show a similar clear and direct line of communication from the Director General and DSO Ricardo Zulueta to Denver Mayores, who communicated with Alvin Labra and then coordinated the same with Aldrin Galicia, who then orchestrated and executed the killing of June Villamor through his gang members. This time, June Villamor was suffocated to death by a plastic bag and held by his own gang members. This unique circumstance shows that the order came from a high official of the Bucor. One usually seeks refuge and protection from his own gang members. The fact that they killed one of their own means and indicates that there were instructions from the top and the gang simply had no choice but to execute. Director General Bantag had a clear motive to effect the murders. For Percy Lapid, it was continued expose by the latter of the issues against the former on his show, Lapid Fire. This is evident from the video sent by DSO Zulueta to Denver Mayores, which was later forwarded to both Alvin Labra and Aldrin Galicia. For June Villamor, it was the attempt to cover up the murder of Percy Lapid. We have initial yet credible intelligence reports that indicate that the money trails described by the PDLs match the bank activity of those charged. The self-confessed gunman stated that the reward for the murder of Percy Lapid was 550,000 pesos. According to the credible intelligence reports, within the period of September 15, 2022 and October 7, 2022, there were indeed cash deposits totaling the amount of 550,000 pesos. In sum, all of the statements given by the PDLs and gunman Joel Escorial, coupled with evidence, corroborate as to the material facts needed to prove the two counts of murder. All departments and agencies involved in this case extend their heartfelt condolences to the families of the victims in these two cases. No amount of cases filed will bring their loved ones back to this world. However, the unfortunate deaths of both Percy Lapid and June Villamor will not go in vain. The investigation has brought to light the institutionalization of a criminal organization within the government. This will be the cause of many reforms in government and the strengthening of current mechanisms to ensure that nothing of this nature will ever happen again. This concerted and coordinated effort of both the DOJ and the DILG is a war against impunity and the continuous and gross disregard of the rule of law. Thank you.
Thank you for that, sir. We'll now open the floor for questions. I will now turn over the mic to ASIC, Nico.
Good morning. The floor is now open to the media. Just as a reminder, kindly raise your hands and wait for an acknowledgement before proceeding to the microphone. Actually, in fact, there are two representatives from the DOJ who will be going around with microphones. Please identify yourself and the entity that you belong to before asking your question. Please also indicate the person to whom you are directing the question to. You are allowed one question and one follow-up to also accommodate the others. Thank you. We're open for questions. Yeah.
Hi, good morning. Nico Bawa from ABS-CBN News. I'd like to know if there was a clear leak from Bantag to the commanders about the order to kill Lapid and Villamor. I understand that some of them simply alluded to or implied that he was the mastermind. But other than those testimonies, are there other things that could, or pieces of evidence that could link to Bantag and Zulueta?
Secretary Mulia would like to answer your question, sir.
The principle that we adopted here in charging the mastermind is the totality of all the facts given to us by all the witnesses and all the circumstances attendant to the killing. So it's a totality test. It is not for us to point out a direct link, but the totality of all the acts points out to the participation of and responsibility of those charged.
My follow-up question then. Normally, when the police and the NBI conduct an investigation, they subpoena everyone who are involved, especially the masterminds. In this particular case, was there a chance for them to be heard or given their side to explain, or was there a subpoena issued for these two masterminds?
No subpoena was issued. That will come because the case was filed already. That will be with the fiscal because they have their rights to counsel and they may answer there. Hindi naman kailangan eh, kasi pinag-aralan niya ng gusto, tinanong lahat ng testigo. And you know, this is an exceptional case. All of these, none of these people would have talked if General Bantag remained as the head of the Bucor. The fear of General Bantag is just tremendous and unbelievable from the eyes of these PDLs. So that... we can say that we thought it best in the conducting the investigation that we let General Bantag answer his charges formally with the fiscal's office.
Next person at the back. Microphone, please.
Pleasant afternoon, sir. John Consulta from GMA 7. First, just like to clarify. We already established earlier on the two principals would be General Bantag and Zulueta. Can you please tell us how are they related or how can we establish their closeness? And we also learned that in the affidavits issued by the prisoners, they said that they had direct contact with Zulueta. What would be our proof aside from the affidavits they have issued, sir?
I think that's... It will be in the, all the affidavits that are there. There are affidavits for more than 10 people pointing to it.
My follow-up question, sir. Now that we have identified General Bantag and Zulueta as principals of this case, will you be leaning in issuing a holding partial order?
They will be issued, now they will be issued subpoenas at their last known addresses because we understand that DSO Zulueta has been in hiding already. He skipped town 4 or 5 days ago. And the General Bantag, we expect to give it to him at the Bucor and his last known address in Caloocan City.
Possible hold departure order, sir? Hold departure? Hold departure order po. HDO?
Well, we will, it's what you call a lookout order. If somebody wants to leave the country, it's a lookout order that we issue. And I think that's the way that the law is enforced in our country.
Next person.
Thank you.
To the left.
Cecil Morelia, sir, of the French News Agency. You portrayed Mr. Bantag's group as a criminal organization. Could you tell us what other crimes did they commit? And I'm particularly interested in whether they had any role in the killing of the PDLs who testified against former Senator De Lima.
Well, I will not go to the case of Senator De Lima here. With the criminal organization, I would say that the beer that was found, that was surrendered by the people, the drugs, the computers, the telephones, the weapons inside Bilibid is a very, very strong indication of the presence of a criminal organization with a centralized purchasing system, a centralized way of doing contraband selling and contraband work within a prison system. I think that itself would tell you that there is a criminal organization lurking within.
My fellow officer. How long has this criminal organization existed? And how many people have been killed by this group?
That's what we are accounting for now. In fact, one of the things that surprised the investigators in this case was the fact that when they went to Eastern Funeral Homes for the autopsy, the first autopsy conducted by the NBI, they were surprised to see more than 30 corpses inside the funeral home. This is now being studied by the police. And we want to know how all of these people died, the cause of death, and the circumstances surrounding their death. But the presence of the criminal organization, we cannot tell now. We will study it, and maybe we can know how long this has been going on. But definitely, there has been criminal activity going on inside the National Libid Prison.
Next. At the back.
Morning, everybody. My name is Nancy Carvalho with Politico.ph. And my question is whoever can would like to answer. With all due respect to the investigators, the NBI and the police, sir, yung kasing affidavits and the statements of the PDLs, some are saying that it's weave, yung very coherent, and in fact, isa yung tono na pinupuntahan, and also apart from the statements, although Nico had asked this earlier, what else do you have that could really link General Bantag? And may Zulueta is fine because he was really named, and there were many instances that he really talked to them, but merong cut, sir. There was a layer of General Bantag, and you said of the statements, talagang siya lang ang, no one can order it. So if no one can order apart from Bantag, sino pa yung, would you say na meron pa bang sa taas o ni Bantag? Kasi marami rin namang, remember, merong 160 people na they feel slighted of Percy Lapid and broadcasts. Tapos, the second question would be the allegations of graft and corruption of Bantag, sir. Nasama ba yun sa investigation as motive ng pagpatay?
I only have one answer to what you said, no? It's the totality of all the statements. I think that we have to stick to that because it is the truth. It is the totality of everything.
Apart, sorry, sir, medyo makulit na talaga. Yung apart from the totality, yeah, we heard that, you know, yung statement.
And I'm going to repeat it again. It's the totality.
Just that.
Totality, yes. Yes.
No other physical evidence na.
There are still things that we have to ask. We're 95% closed, but there's 5% that we want to find out about this.
Thank you so much.
Next.
And congratulations.
Yes, Jairo.
Okay, good morning. Jairo Bulledo from Rappler. I only have one question because natanong na po yung sa higher up. General Bantag already said na hindi siya magpapakulong. Mayroon pa siyang non-verbatim po na word na parang magkamatayan na lang daw po ng gobyernong ito. Ano po yung mga measures na gagawin natin aside from the HTO para ma-ensure natin na magiging accountable si Director General Bantag for this crime, alleged crime? Thank you.
We will furnish him documents that he can defend himself with so that he can be informed of all the charges against him and all the testimonies against him so he can answer intelligibly. We will give him due process. He will have the right to counsel, as all people are entitled to the right to counsel. Besides that, all of these words are not within our grasp. Kami ho rito, law enforcement po ang iniisip namin. Hindi ho kami nag-iisip ng iba. Pinapatupad lang po namin ang batas. Wala ho kami ibang motibo rito.
Kung ano pong mangyari na sa proseso, alam naman natin, may proseso po ito. May karapatan ang isa para sagutin ang bintang sa kanya. Kung ano ang maging desisyon, kailangan ipapatupad po namin ito. At andyan po ang NBI at PNP para ipatupad ang magiging desisyon po dito sa kaso.
Next.
Hi, sirs. Linawin lang po namin yung motibo sa pagpatay kay Percy Lapid. kung ano po yung kumbaga malinaw na motibo doon po sa pagbabanat po niya. And sir, yung mga inmates po, yung sa mga dating kaso, I know na natanong na kanina, pero not specific sa kaso naman ni Secretary De Lima, pero meron bang mga nabanggit, for example, na previous cases involving Bantag and Zulueta in connection with deaths dun sa iba pang mga prisoners doon?
Yan po, susuriin din namin po rin. Kasi nga, marami akong tanong at mawalabas. Kasi marami akong nagsasalita ko. Hindi nagsasalita natin. Marami akong informasyon at mapasok. Mapaplayo po rin natin ito. Hindi mo na uubos ang informasyon at mapasok sa amin. Uubos ang nangyayari sa loob po.
Next. Yes, good morning. I'm Donna Pasibugan from Inquirer. So, talking about due process, so the how does the presence of the DOJ, no less than the secretary, affect, how will it affect the process now, considering that it will still undergo preliminary investigation? Does this mean that this will automatically be filed in court? Charges filed.
This will be evaluated by the prosecutors. I couldn't handle the work of the prosecutors. But probably more important is the fact that the court member appoints to be the ones to decide. The prosecutor's job is to really accept the function and not the mission. Meron kasi iniisip natin isa na ang PI is like a judicial process, not an executive process. That has to be done.
Wala itong sir, wala itong deviation from the normal process where the
investigation just to ensure that we need the report, the FBI were in close contact and the police were in close contact. That is the role that we play. It's a leadership role that we play as secretaries of the Secretary of Justice. We sigurado na natin maagal po lahat na makinagay ang gobyerno for public interest.
Okay, we'll be entertaining two more representatives of the media. First, yes sir. Yes, Mike.
Sir Benjamin Pultapoff sa Philippine News Agency. Sir, tatluhin ko na yung tanong. First question is, would you like to reply to the insinuations made by General Bantag that efforts were made to oust him as early as August this year? Tapos, second question ko, sir, yung seemingly contradicting autopsy reports, will they both be included in the investigation or will one be excluded in the other? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yung conflict lang, sir.
Without affidavit of the persons who knew about how Villamar was killed. Any I came in time that they did the first autopsy. The second autopsy was carried to the to give all the information available already, because this was done a week after the NDI. So when Dr. Fortune conducted her autopsy, she already knew about the dying declaration, and she already knew about the affidavit of the persons who were there when the killing of the lab. So there's no conflict.
Sir, yung first question ko ulit, yung Mr. Bantag is claiming persecution. Tapos yung third question ko, sir, yung biglang nagano. Okay, sir, yung first question na lang muna, nakalimutan ko.
Persecution is not the game of the DOJ. They are here to seek justice. And I don't think that somebody who is the director general of the people can be persecuted. It's one of the case of Batangas, the Pasang Island. And if you look at it, he will probably be the highest official that is not ever charged with a case of this term. It just has to happen. And it's not really needed to go around by CBC.
Last question.
Sir? Sa DCRS po, si Boy Gonzales, paano natin mapipigilan lumabas ng bansa kung lookout bulletin lamang kung wala tayong hold departure order? At isa pa po, magkakaroon po ba ng panel para mapabilis ang investigasyon ng DOJ?
Thank you. Sky General Azurin po and Director De Lemos. Where is General Bantag and Superintendent Ricardo Zulueta as of now? Where are they? I mean,
my test. So again, I'm pleading to Solueta to just surrender right now. Just like the gunman who surrendered, napag-isipan niya na in danger ang buhay niya. And I'm asking each and everyone who's watching right now could give any information to the whereabouts of Solueta. Napaka-importante niya po rito. Again, I would like to tell everyone na sa pamunuan po ng ating Pangulo, no, magtatrabaho po kami. Hindi ho biro ito yung mga dinimanda rito, pero we have to look at the evidence objectively. Kaya ito ho, ang Department of Justice, ang DILG, ang PNP, ang NBI, from now on, parati ho kami magsasama to always resolve on cases. Magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat.
Well, I was asked to be here today to address everybody about this investigation. I think that the resolution of this case with regards to the investigation came at a very good pace because of the cooperation of the police and the NBI. Their professionalism was something to behold. I think that we can put our faith back to our law enforcement people. And that I'd like to ask Solueta and DG Bantag to surrender and to face the charges. If they are innocent, the law will uphold them. If they're guilty, then they will have to face the consequence. Eh, ganun lang ho talaga ang ano eh, ang sitwasyon ngayon eh. Mahirap talaga to fall from grace, especially from a very high perch. May sinasabi nga ng iba, yung impunity nito kakaiba. Kasi nagbubukas pa lang ang mga facts na nangyari sa loob ng Muntinlupa, sa Bilibid. Ngayon, marami nagtatanong sa amin tungkol hindi lang nga sa alak tsaka sa drugs na nasa loob. Marami pa tinatanong sa amin, ano ba yung nangyari sa mga drug lord na namatay? 18 drug lord ang namatay within the span of 75 days. All of COVID and cremated right after. Marami ho talaga mga krimen pa na ating kung kailangan tingnan or allegations of crimes. And the criminal activity inside has to stop. Prior to this, no? Prior to the case of Percy Lapid, the DOJ was already working on reforms of our correction system. Kasi nga, it is the biggest mega prison in the world. It is not easy to manage. Pangalawa, ang talagang trend ngayon sa penology ay talagang i-cut down na ang sizes ng mga prisons or mga piitan, mga kulungan to a maximum size of 2,000 to 2,500 people. Ito po na-propose na natin ito. Kaya nga, ito po meron na hong ginagawa ang DOJ dito matagal na. Kasi ito nga ang produkto ng, ito talaga ang problema na na-identify na nung araw pa. So, we have to move on from this. We have to learn our lessons from this. Kinakailangan tungkol sa nangyayari sa loob ng Bilibid. Ngayon, na sinasagot namin ang tanong, ba't marami pa rin tanong? Mas marami kayong tinatanong sa amin. Eh, things that you took as a matter of fact before, ngayon hinarap namin sa inyo, parang hirap tanggapin. Pero yun po yung katotohanan eh. Mahirap tanggapin ang katotohanan. Pero yun po ang totoo. Hindi, wala ho kami mapapala rito mag-invento ng uusigin. We will not invent, we do not want to persecute anybody. Believe me, wala ho tayong gustong apihin dito. Nilalabas lang namin ang prueba na ibinigay sa amin ng mga tao na sasalita na may kaalaman sa mga pangyayari sa loob ng bilangguan. Tanggapin natin po na ganun ho talaga. Mahirap tanggapin ang katotohanan. And this is the truth. We have no motive here but to unmask the truth so that justice may be done. Maraming salamat po.